Hi, my name's Christine Stimson, and I am a resident of Laramie. I was born here, and I'm a single mom of a 12-year-old boy. His name is Luke. And I've been in attending a church in Laramie for probably since 1979 or so. And I was baptized there and continued to just attend and go to Bible studies and such things. As I grew up, in living with my child and stuff, it turned out it was just really hard to focus on, a lesson, because I'd be trying to chase my child down and keep him under control and things like that. So I didn't really study that much on my own, and mostly I would go and sit in the pew, take part in a few things, and that type of thing. Well, as time went on, I started to not feel like I was part of the congregation, really. Just not really close to God. I can't explain that any more than that. And that just kept building up and up to where probably a year ago, I was just not focusing on God. I was definitely putting other people before God, putting everything else before God, but in my heart knowing that wasn't right, knowing that's not what I wanted to do. The church we were going to was pretty conservative in behavior and worship, and that proved difficult for both my son and me. It was just hard for him to just sit quietly, and then it was hard for me to help him do that. So we ended up going less and less and less. Let's say about in the fall, I was looking around at different congregations, up in the phone book and on their websites, and just feeling uncomfortable about wanting to go somewhere else, but feeling the need to do something. So while I was in that search, I received a flyer from the Whitewater deal, and I called Chad, and we talked about a lot of things, and I had a lot of questions because I wanted to be in a congregation that really followed the Bible. That was real important to me. Emphasized studying and just built people up more. I wasn't exactly sure what I was looking for as far as a worship situation. I'd come from a non-instrumental church and non-instrumental music church, and so I was like really thinking that things had to be a certain way or else it wasn't really worship or it wasn't worshiping the right way. So you know, Whitewater's a different experience. Totally different experience. That took a little bit of adjusting to, but the more I talked to Chad and then I talked to Sam some, the more I also started to realize what a gap of understanding I had between grace and faith and works and grace and all that. I was very confused about that. And I had been thinking, you know, I don't really feel like I am a Christian. I don't feel like, you know, I was feeling like back at the beginning, like I'd just been exposed to it all, but had enough knowledge to be dangerous. And that was about it. So I just wanted to not just rededicate myself, but to just go back to the very clear the decks and go, you know, I thought, am I close to God? Am I even following Him? And I just came to my own decision of, no, I don't think so. And is it what I want? Yes, it is what I want. So then, after reading and studying on my own, which was pretty important to me, and praying, I decided that what I had been doing was maybe a misunderstanding in my own heart and head of perhaps what the Bible was saying. I'm not entirely sure that explains it very well, but I knew I wanted to be closer to God, so I decided to, first of all, you know, I wanted Christ to be the Lord of my life, which He wasn't, and I wanted that to really change. And I wanted to, I was missing a whole bunch of stuff on the Holy Spirit. I mean, it was like I almost had no clue. I knew it was out there, but I didn't exactly know what the Holy Spirit did. And so I was missing out on a whole nother part of God. You know, and the whole time I've been in another congregation or whatever. And so I wanted that. I wasn't plugged into that at all. And so that's why I decided to go through baptism again. I felt like, and I believed, I didn't just feel it, but I believed in my brain and just everywhere within me that that's where I needed to go. And is everything perfect now? Not as of today. I had, you know, it's trials still come, things I still, you know, my life is my life, but the direction is definitely different. I have no regrets. I did what I needed to do, and I'm glad I did it.